CDL General Knowledge Practice Test, Questions and Answers, updated for 2022. True or false? When backing up, you should always back up toward the driver's side. The answer, true. For optimal line of view, always back up toward the driver's side. How many emergency reflective triangles should you have with you in your truck? A4, B2, C3, D5. The answer, C3. What is an escape ramp? A, a place for truckers to relax. B, first thing you should try during brake failure. C, made to stop a runaway vehicle safely without injuring drivers and passengers. The answer? C, an escape ramp is made to stop a runaway vehicle safely without injuring drivers and passengers. True or false? There are three types of vehicles that can get stuck on a railroad highway crossing. The answer? False. The two types of vehicles that can get stuck on a railroad highway crossing are a single axle tractor pulling long trailers with landing gear set to accommodate a tandem axle tractor and low slung units such as car carriers, low boy, possum belly livestock trailer, and moving vans. What is the proper braking technique for going down a long, steep downgrade? A, put the vehicle in neutral and apply the brakes at 50%. B, downshift and apply the brakes. C, apply the brakes hard enough to feel a slowdown. When speed has reduced by approximately 5 miles per hour below your safe speed, release brakes. When your speed increases to your safe speed, repeat steps 1 and 2. The answer? C, apply the brakes hard enough to feel a slowdown. When speed has reduced by approximately 5 miles per hour below your safe speed, release brakes. When your speed increases to your safe speed, repeat steps 1 and 2. Which of the following are key steering system parts? A, steering arms. B, pitman arm. C, drag link. D, all of the above. The answer? D, all of the above. If you become tired while driving, what should you do? A, turn your music up loud. B, pull over and get some rest. C, have some coffee. The answer? B, pull over and get some rest. What are some signs of a distracted driver? A, vehicles drifting in and out of lanes. B, drivers using cell phones while driving. C, changes in vehicle speed. D, all of the above. The answer? D, all of the above. What are two causes of tire fires? A, overinflated tires and duals that don't touch. B, underinflated tires and duals that touch. C, driving too long. The answer? B, underinflated tires and duals that touch. What are some suspension system defects? A. Cracked or broken spring hangers. B. Missing or broken leaves in any leaf spring. C. Leaking shock absorbers. D. All of the above. The answer? D. All of the above. What is the minimum tread depth for front tires? A. 2/32 of an inch tread depth. B. 3/32 of an inch tread depth. C. 4/32 of an inch tread depth. The answer? C. 4/32 of an inch tread depth. As a truck driver, how often should you inspect the securement of your cargo? A. Within the first 25 miles. B. Within the first 50 miles of a trip and every 150 miles or every 3 hours, whichever occurs first. C. Within the first 100 miles of a trip and every 500 miles or every 3 hours, whichever occurs first. The answer? B. Within the first 50 miles of a trip and every 150 miles or every 3 hours, whichever occurs first. When backing, why is it important to use a helper? A. So you have someone to talk to. B. There are blind spots you can't see. That's why a helper is important. The helper should stand near the back of your vehicle where you can see the helper. Before you begin backing, work out a set of hand signals you both understand. Agree on a signal for stop. C. None of the above. The answer? B. There are blind spots you can't see. That's why a helper is important. The helper should stand near the back of your vehicle where you can see the helper. Before you begin backing, work out a set of hand signals that you both understand. Agree on a signal for stop. What are the two special conditions where you should downshift? A. Going up a hill and turning. B. Going down a hill and slowing down. C. Before entering a curve and before starting down a hill. The answer? C. Before entering a curve and before starting down a hill. How far ahead do CDL manuals say you should look? A. 2 minutes. B. 12 to 15 seconds. C. 20 to 30 seconds. The answer? B. 12 to 15 seconds. True or false? BC type fire extinguishers are designed to work on electrical fires and burning liquids. The answer? True. True or false? You should turn wide left before turning right. The answer? False. Which of the following is a cause of a vehicle fire? A. Underinflated tires. B. Electrical system issues. C. Spilled fuel. D. All of the above. The answer? D. All of the above. If it is foggy out, what is the best advice for driving in fog? A. Don't drive in fog. B. Use high beams. C. Speed up. Attempt to drive out of the fog. The answer? A. Don't drive in fog. You wear corrective glasses or contact lenses. When is it okay to drive without them? A. Short trips. B. When parking. C. Never. The answer? C. Never. Which of the following is something that needs to be checked on the front of your vehicle during your walk around inspection? A. Check that the low beams are on. B. Check that turn signals both work properly. C. Check that hazard lights work properly. D. All of the above. The answer? D. All of the above. When stopped on a divided highway, where should your reflectors be placed? A. 10 feet, 100 feet, and 200 feet toward approaching traffic. B. 20 feet, 50 feet, and 100 feet toward approaching traffic. C. 5 feet, 50 feet, and 100 feet toward approaching traffic. The answer? A. 10 feet, 100 feet, and 200 feet toward approaching traffic. What is black ice? A. A thin layer of ice that makes the road look wet. B. Ice that turns black when you touch it. C. A layer of ice that forms on your windshield. The answer? A. A thin layer of ice that makes the road look wet. What are two things that every safe driver looks ahead for? A. Rest stops and restaurants. B. Traffic and road conditions. C. Wildlife and local attractions. The answer? B. Traffic and road conditions. While you are driving, you are confronted by an aggressive driver. What do you do? A. Pull over. B. Speed up. C. Report the aggressive driver to the proper authorities. The answer? C. Report the aggressive driver to the proper authorities. True or false? Aggressive driving and road rage are the same thing. The answer? False. What is the best way to use in-vehicle communication equipment safely? A. Post on social media while on the road. B. Use hands-free devices at all times. C. Use a laptop to keep in communication with family. The answer? B. Use hands-free devices at all times. True or false? It is okay to safely remove the radiator cap as long as the engine isn't overheated. The answer? False. Before starting down a hill, what is the proper gear that your vehicle should be in? A. Shift into a low gear. B. The same gear you were in before the hill. C. Shift up a gear. The answer? A. Shift into a low gear. There are three types of emergency equipment you must have. Which of the following is not one of them? A, police scanner. B, red reflective triangles. C, spare electrical fuses. D, fire extinguisher. The answer? A, police scanner. Why is it a good idea to put the starter switch key in your pocket during pre-inspection? A, so you don't lose the key. B, so no one moves the vehicle while you are inspecting underneath. C, so no one tries to steal your vehicle. The answer? B, so no one moves the vehicle while you are inspecting underneath. If you are driving twice as fast, how much does your stopping distance increase? A, 2, B, 4. The answer? B, 4. What is hydroplaning? A, when an airplane makes an emergency landing on a highway. B, when water or slush collects on the roadway and your tires can't make contact with the surface of the road and you lose control of the vehicle. C, when water freezes on the road and makes the surface look wet. The answer? B, when water or slush collects on the roadway and your tires can't make contact with the surface of the road and you lose control of the vehicle. If you are driving a 40-foot vehicle at 55 miles per hour, how many seconds of following distance should you allow? A, 2, B, 4, C, 5. The answer, C, 5. How are hydraulic brakes tested for leaks? A, check around the tires for liquid on the ground. B, pump the brake pedal 3 times, apply firm pressure to the pedal and hold for 5 seconds. The pedal should not move. C, listen for squeaky noises when pressing on brakes. The answer, B, pump the brake pedal 3 times, apply firm pressure to the pedal and hold for 5 seconds. The pedal should not move. True or false? You've had a couple beers. Having a cup of coffee and some fresh air will sober you up. The answer? False. It is important to always check your tires. What are some issues you may encounter? A, dual tires that come in contact with each other or other parts of the vehicle. B, too much or too little air pressure. C, tread separation. D, all of the above. The answer? D, all of the above. What is the most important factor for doing a vehicle inspection? A, cleanliness. B, safety. C, to waste time before you leave. The answer, B, safety. What are some exhaust system defects? A, loose, broken, or missing pipes, mufflers, or tailpipes. B, missing brackets, clamps, bolts, or nuts. C, exhaust system parts rubbing against fuel system parts, tires, or other moving parts on the vehicle. D, all of the above. The answer? D, all of the above. true or false? An empty truck takes more time to brake than a fully loaded one. The answer? True. There are three things that add up the total stopping distance. Which of these is not one of them? A, perception distance. B, braking distance. C, reaction distance. D, sight distance. The answer? D, sight distance. How much space should you leave between you and the vehicle in front of you? A, 1 second for every 10 feet of trailer under 40 miles per hour. B, 2 seconds for every 10 feet of trailer under 40 miles per hour. C, 4 seconds for every 10 feet of trailer under 40 miles per hour. The answer? A, 1 second for every 10 feet of trailer under 40 miles per hour. Which of these are warning signs of fatigue? A, heavy eyelids or frequent blinking. B, yawning repeatedly or rubbing eyes. C, drifting between lanes. D, all of the above. The answer, D, all of the above. True or false? Night driving is less dangerous because there are fewer vehicles on the road. The answer? False. Which of the following can be considered a road hazard? A, work zones. B, foreign objects. C, off-ramps and on-ramps. D, all of the above. The answer? D, all of the above. What is a glare? A, a nasty look from a distracted driver. B, being blinded for a short time by a bright light. C, a camera flash. The answer? B, being blinded for a short time by a bright light. What types of vehicles are required to have anti-lock braking systems? A, truck tractors with air brakes built on or after March 1, 1997. B, other air brake vehicles, trucks, buses, trailers, and converter dollies built on or after March 1, 1998. C, hydraulically braked trucks and buses with gross weight vehicle rating of 10,000 pounds or more, built on or after March 1, 1999. D, all of the above. The answer, D, all of the above. Which of these can cause a skid? A, over braking. B, over steering. C, driving too fast. D, all of the above. The answer? D, all of the above.